Shalom, Rastafari, Salamta. You know, before we continue, we want to make mention, like Deuteronomy chapter 16. I believe it's verse 18. You know, it's the beginning of Torah portion study, Ferachochene, judges and officers shalt thou appoint thee, and all thy gates, or something similar to that. And we recall that when we read through that, it kind of reminded us of New Testament scripture where it says, you know, like, if you don't want people to be judging you, judge thyself. But of course, you know, judge righteously. Judge a righteous judgment. So basically, this is because we're going to be reasoning on the video, The True Order of Rastafari, which is a video that Tobijah uploaded. And it's not that we got anything against him or we're taking sides. If truth leans towards one side, then there's nothing we could do about it, you know. You'll read all throughout scripture that there's always a leaning, an inclination that takes place when truth is established. But nonetheless, let us continue. So, you know, because the individual expressed, it was pretty obvious to receive how he was expressing the discomfort of criticism. It's as simple as if one does not want to be judged, then there's no need, in fact, of others judging one if one is diligent to judge himself properly and accordingly. As a matter of fact, we recall having had exercised that right in Jah Almighty, you know, and it's our right, and we have every right to exercise our own judgment as long as it is true and righteous judgment according. And let us read verse 20 of chapter 16, book of Deuteronomy, to make it more clear how it is that we judge that which is altogether as a body of completeness, not lacking, altogether just shalt thou follow, that thou mayest live and inherit the land which the Lord thy God giveth thee. So that is the judgment that we are to pass upon, even dying thyself, if it be the case, a complete and just righteous judgment in Christ. And so if we walk that exemplary life, then we shall live, as it went on to say, we shall live the days of our lives. And what is being said is that if one's live, you know, keep the covenant, that the days of our pilgrimage upon this earth shall be fulfilled, fully filled. We shall live the number of days that has been assigned to I and I upon this pilgrimage. It's like we're on a mission, and so we you know, if depending on the number of days that consist of your mission upon earth, then if you keep covenant, then you'll live every one of those days. For example, when Moses goes on to say, this day I am 120 years of age, it's referring to that Jah has promised a number of days, to be the completion of my pilgrimage upon earth. And this day, you know, Jah has kept his promise, and I have fulfilled the number of days required for pilgrimage or mission completion. Now I shall return to our people. And so it's not death, really. It's kind of like he made it. It's like, wow, he lived every one of them days. You know, the mission was not aborted, was not cut short because of lack of will and lack of, you know, obedience and stuff like that. So, you know, I had never thought about that until this very moment. And so we give thanks and praise to the Father Almighty, His Majesty, Haile Selassie first, in and through Christ, Yeshua, Yehoshua HaMashiach. And so, yeah, let us continue. So we're not trying to disrespect the brother. As a matter of fact, I personally declare this to be the state of captivity, on his behalf, in his part, and being captive to evil forces or lack thereof, but more specifically pride. You know, pride. We'll speak about pride, but it's not a small matter, we would say. So spiritual warfare takes place in the mind, but it's not limited to, and so be sure that it'll manifest into the physical. Not all of our thoughts are our own. There are good thoughts and bad thoughts. We must know the voice of our Father. We must know the voice of our Shepherd. We must know the voice of Christ Jesus calling I and I to return and not let one of our thoughts go astray, you know? Because there are some voices out there that are not of good, and so they cannot be of Jesus Christos. And so we totally discard, discredit, and abandon those false thoughts. Let we make mention that a Gentile, you know, pointed out in a video, and it's really basic, but I would have never thought about it. And so, you know, in faith, they are our brothers. And I'm saying because it was not a Rastafari individual or something like that, just random video. Well, not random, Jah placed it upon I and thy path. But he makes mention that if ones are confronted with bad thoughts, you know, that one can exercise our Jah-given ability to declare dominion, reclaim dominion, or proclaim dominion and exclude them exclude that presence from our land, right? And by simply declaring the authority and the name under which all authority is granted. And so, like, for instance, like, oh, you know, you come across like stealing something, then all you have to do is exercise truth and speak against it and say, like, you know, you are not a good thought, and I command you in the power and authority of Jesus Christus to exit, you know, to, you don't gotta go home, but but this ain't your home, you know, so you know, go somewhere else. And you know, that sounds like pretty simple, right? But I think that's genius. I had not thought about that. So next time, whenever I come up with a bad idea or bad thought comes into mind, not that we are bad, but bad entities are putting those thoughts within I and that. So all we have to do is you know, lay it to that thought straight and let them know who's boss and under who authority everything is, and just do away with that thought, right? So let us continue. I just felt that was necessary to make mention because it's something so simple we would think that I personally wasn't even inclining to ever even think about that. So yeah, it's we gotta exercise, you know, the authority of Jesus Christus above all things in some of these spiritual battles. So let us continue by, let's see. Excuse us for this. So chapter 12 goes on to say, these are the statutes and judgments which ye shall observe to do them in the land which the Lord God of thy fathers giveth thee to possess it, all the days that ye live upon the earth. Upon the earth, being specific. You know, if there wasn't a life somewhere else apart from earth, then it would not be necessary to present that the sentence in being so specific. Ye shall utterly destroy all the places, and this is like the exercising of destroying or doing away with evil thoughts, wherein the nations which ye shall possess served their gods upon the high mountains and upon the hills and under every green tree. And you shall overthrow their altars, you know, I'll break their pillars and burn their groves with fire. And you shall hew down the graven images of their gods and destroy the names of them out of that place. You shall not do to the Lord your God. You shall not do so to the Lord your God, but to the place which the Lord your God shall choose out of all your tribes to put his name there, even to his habitation. Shall ye seek, and thy there thou shalt come. So it's up for grabs, basically. It's like whatever Jah says goes. So even Old Testament is indicating how there's going to be changes in the New Testament. But I mean, that's not all that relative. But at least the beginning was how we are to proclaim dominion and do away with these negativities. Now, let us we took notes on the video because we really find this to be a worthy topic, being that in this case Tobijah is captive of pride, and who knows if there's other demonic false thoughts, along with pride, as you know, excuse that. Who knows if there's other like false thoughts, you know, helping pride to keep this potentially good individual captive and astray. So we took note. So need to speak, but we need to speak truth. He goes on to say, tell your wrong leader, elder, how long this, that, think that you are, tell wrong. Okay, so basically this is pride. You know, the individual presents himself that he doesn't want to do the video, but he's going to do it. So either you do or you don't. You know, we don't choose left, we don't choose right, we keep straight. No need to mention that you don't want to do something if you are in fact doing it, and especially if it takes a whole hour of your life. And so obviously you did want to do it enough to where you set aside 1 hour dedicated to this, which you claimed at first you did not want to do. So let us continue. So this video is to tell everyone that Ras Iadonis is wrong, and Tobijah chooses not to mention Ras Iadonis' name for whatever reason throughout the whole video, because he is so insignificant that it's no need to make mention his name. Do not, brothers and sisters in spirit and truth, do not take this against him. This is demonic activity, you know, doing what it does best and causing, if we were to be ignorant of the fact that he's captive under pride, under the powerless of pride, then it'll stir up some of us, and then it'll create a conflict that is nonsense and not to be. This is what wicked entities or powers lack thereof do. They manifest, they make manifest evil thoughts, and so don't take this against him, Tobijah. Keep in mind, you know, have compassion in the sense that he is captive to the false thought of pride. He's been overtaken, overcome, and held captive to pride. So he says that he's going to address that when Ras Iadonis is wrong, that he's going to address that if any so-called leaders, elders, who cares how long they've been in the faith or whatever, that say this and that think you are telling right, that he's going to tell them that they're wrong, that he's about truth. So in reality, he's putting a good message if you really listen to it, but he needs to flip that message and now that he put it out there, put himself into the context of him that needs to receive it, basically, because it's twisting, it's the wickedness of spiritual warfare, how it's twisting everything. He's saying things that are true, but he should be directing that towards him, but he cannot see that because he's in a state of marvel, of wonder, of like he's too possessed to perceive. He's been bewitched, he's lost the ability to perceive. And so for instance, that example we gave earlier, okay, let's not go to that. Nonetheless, he's not willing to listen, look, or anything. He's like, you could present a case and build a good case and try to show to him and prove to him that some matter is not the case, but he will not see that, as we have read in his responses. He's only wandering and stuck in that false thought where he is right because he is so much, you know. It the ego and not wanting to let it go and not wanting to put himself aside and seek a truly beneficial motive that'll lead towards progress, the common good, the progress of the commonwealth. So let us continue. So it makes mention that Ras Iadonis, he talks about everything in his life, and that he has a video log for everything, and that he's got thousands and millions of videos. Well, that's not the case, you know. As a matter of fact, one of Yadon is pretty private, to be honest. So that's that. That's a lie. You know, everything he puts out is good information, and it's quite accurate. And if it's not, then present the case. Now, this is where pride kind of like exalts itself. He goes on to say, I extended my hand out to him. Okay, let me just stop right there. Let me remind everyone that we're not trying to make fun of him. We're not trying to choose sides. We're not. This is real. This is spiritual warfare. And it's right in front of our faces, right? And so, you know, please bear with the video. I don't even feel, not that I don't feel comfortable putting out this message, but it's like something it must be that those bad vibes that don't want me to put it out, right? But no, it's kind of like, it's because in no way are we trying to disrespect or humiliate or criticize or no negative thoughts are being made manifest into the flesh as far as what we're doing. And so we just want everyone to know and to bear with us, all right? We're not talking bad about anyone. We're not, this is real. We can learn from this, all right? We can learn from this. So forgive Tobijah, right? But if you ever get right with Jah, then you'll see that this falling short was in fact an opportunity for Rastafari to come together and kind of get a closer look on what spiritual warfare is all about. So this is where Satan exalts himself, because he's like, I extended my hand out to him. It's like I was gonna offer my advice to Wendell Yadam. I took the liberty, the time of my beautiful and life to go and help him, because I am so full of help and I am the greatest. And he didn't say that, obviously, but this is the way Satan thinks. Like I would not have done that. Oh, I you know, even the case of the Kevra Nagesh, chapter 100 concerning the fallen angels and stuff like that. It's that pride. It's like, oh, but we, oh Almighty El Elyon, we would not have broken your covenant or gone against your command and stuff like that. And Jah's all like, man, shut up. You don't even know what you're talking about. You can't go against my commandments. I made you that way. You don't even have free will. It's like, what are you talking about? No, but Adam, he ate, and you clearly told him not to eat. We would not have eaten, you know? It's like, man, what? That's vanity. That's insanity. That's imagination. Jah just told him, you can't. There's nothing you can do about it, you know? And so they bargain to go to Earth, and what happens? They lose their minds. They go crazy. They go nuts. It's like they couldn't contain themselves. They were not met. They were not made for that, you know? And so, yeah, thus resulting in Noah's flood. And so, let us not get into that, but let us continue. So, goes into the followers and that. Okay, so one thing that we do have to side on him, I guess, bad word, But one thing that we agree is that he did mention that a lot of different individuals were kind of responding to him and saying that Ras Iadonis can put you in your place, and that he knows, and that we agree in the sense what he said that everyone was kind of like, no one really, I guess, no one really presented a case, but rather told them that Ras Iadonis can totally disprove you or something. Kind of like I don't even know how to explain this, but it's kind of weird. But really, what's going on is that everyone has to know what they know for themselves. We can't be saying like, oh, if Ras Iadonis hears what you're saying, he's totally going to disprove that. Either we keep quiet or we handle it ourselves. You know, we can't depend on someone else, because first of all, we're not that someone else, and we don't know where that someone else stands, you know, concerning whatever particular matter. And so we can't be like, oh, we're gonna call Ras Iadonis and he's gonna set you straight. That's not the way it works. You know, if we're in that stage, it doesn't mean that that's bad. I mean, we're just learning. We're all learning. But yeah, let's stay away from that, because he did, you know, the evil entity, in this case, exercising complete control over a potentially good individual, uses that against us. It's kind of like throwing it in our face. It's like, what? None of you can I guess, like, build a case against this. None of you can defend the cause, but you all have to go to Ras Iadonis. And yes, Ras Iadonis is very knowledgeable. In fact, it don't matter how much we think we know, his experience and the vast amounts of knowledge that he's been exposed to can far outweigh any little recent you know, findings that we may have come across, because his body has been built in more fully, and so he can extract out of his bank account like nothing, you know. And he's got stuff left and right that he could go, that the spirit could go through archives and you know, just pull out for evidence upon request. So yeah, it is wise to seek counsel, but let us not you know, kind of like play that role where, oh, we're gonna, you know, whenever, like, we're not gonna say anything, but he'll put you in your place, you know. Let's avoid that. Rather, let us be wise, and if we really can't address the issue, let us just remain silent, because it's more of a kind of like, it's a decency, you know. So let us continue. You know, I pray that ones don't get offended by that, but it's the truth, you know. So let us continue. And so, okay, another thing, he mentioned that he could be lying. I mean, but I'm not. If it is the case that what he said is correct, then we're, this is how we choose to address it. He made mention that many Rastafari told them not to post any videos, to stop uploading videos and stuff like that. Honestly, that's trying to exercise domination, and we Rastafari don't do that. You know, honestly, we would encourage Tobijah to put out more videos, but concerning truth, it's the only thing, you know. So we're not to say that don't upload videos. It's like, I mean, you got free will, right? We can't take that from you, but if you do upload, they should be of truth. And if you don't have truth to upload, then you know, just chill for a while. And so, you know, just, this is kind of like for all Rastafari, you know, like, let's not reward evil for evil. So let us continue. And he goes on to mention that the biggest critics are his own people, Ethiopians. that fight him down. Your people. That it doesn't surprise him, because it's that same people that even killed, he says, killed Jesus and killed his majesty. That the Ethiopians killed his majesty. We totally disagree. That's nonsense right there. That's something someone captive of wicked thoughts would say. You know, that's a prisoner of war right there. No one killed Jesus. As a matter of fact, he took on that sacrifice himself. Doesn't he tell Pilate that, because Pilate says, like, don't you know that I can free you? It's like, you ain't got no power of yourself. Like, I'm here because I want to do the Father's will. I'm here because I want to. I give it up my life. But him who giveth up his life for the sake of Jesus Christus, the same shall receive it. And him that saveth his life, the same shall lose it. And so, it's like, first of all, no one killed Jesus. He offered himself as the perfect sacrifice. And Ethiopians did not kill his majesty. As a matter of fact, that's a whole different case. No one killed his majesty. How could you be saying that someone killed his majesty and Jesus? Then honestly, like, logically, people could come at you by saying that, then thus we can conclude that you are inferring, or in fact stating as a fact, that his imperial majesty, Haile Selassie I, is dead, and that Jesus Christus is dead. And so we don't, you know, that's what other people will bring to the table, right? As far as using the error that you presented as fact and use it against you and prove how you are not even all that precise and accurate in your own, you know, spirituality, religion, whatever. So yeah, basically, but more important than that is so basically it's like, yeah, it's my own people that fight me down. Cause remember, Satan thinks he's everything. He's all about the ego, and he don't want to let it go. It's all about me. I selfishly. So it's like, it don't surprise. You gotta keep in mind, this is Satan speaking. So in the form of Tobijah. So he says it don't surprise me, cause it's even them that killed Christ and his majesty. It's like, so Christ, I mean, who cares about him? But I do remember that it's the same people that went after him too. And also that one dude they call him the Emperor of Ethiopia, they killed him too. It's like, this is clear, like false thoughts and you know, being manipulated by pride, because how could you put Christ second and his majesty second, third, or whatever? You can't. It's like, me. It's the same. Don't surprise me, because those people killed Christ too. It's about Christ. This is about Christ. It's not about you. It's not about who. First of all, no one killed Christ. Yes, no one killed his majesty, but it's not about you. You see what I'm trying. I mean, I can't explain it all that well, but it's not about him. So basically he's turning this into, like, well, the evil spirit, right? He's turning this into, it's not about what I can do for Christ. It's about what Christ, yes, and his majesty could do for me, you know? And basically that's what I got out of it. It's pride, it's pride, it's pride. So let us continue. Well, actually, my notes here says that, you know, when we receive help, so what him do for us? So what can he do for us? Or what can we provide for the body in Christ, right? Well, show us I write here, in scripture. Because he's presenting all kinds of like accusations and stuff like that, but false not even accusations, because what is he accusing? He hasn't, like, he's saying this, saying that, but he hasn't like stated an actual okay, you know, he hasn't even established the case. Like, oh, Wendem Yadam said this. Oh, he said that. Oh, my people are against me because of this, because of that. You see? So let us continue that. Yeah, that's kind of like off track, but nonetheless. So then he goes on to like how he addressed, how he confronted Wendem Yadam, how he tried to reach, how this is Satan talking. So I've sent him a message. I addressed him properly and correctly and morally, and I am so full of light. But he, you know, it's the same game. I mean, devil knows no different tactics. If the old ones have been working, why need him change, right? So then he goes into the video and he shows the message he posted. This is what he posted to Wendem Yadam, and this is the message he sent. Know it not thou that the parables are of a greater significance than the literal, something like that. That basically saying that the metaphysical, the metaphysical like interpretation of the parables are greater. First of all, right off the bat, we can conclude that that is a false statement, because His Imperial Majesty clearly warns us of the philosophy of greater and superiority. And he also makes mention, you know, in the Lutheran Christmas special interview, which is a very good interview, I would say. He makes mention that, okay, kind of got addressed, that the Bible is not to be, my bad, I apologize, that the Bible is not to be taken in parts. It's supposed to be received as a whole. And so we cannot say that the literal interpretation is less important than the metaphysical interpretation. We are to receive it as a whole, equally as important. One cannot prevail without the other. All members of the body must function as one in order to be whole. And so right off the bat, we can completely abandon this statement. But then let us continue. And then he continues by saying, thou being a master of Israel, know it not, you know it not the, let's go to that scripture, because I kind of forgot it, to be honest. But that ain't no friendly way to approach. It's like calling someone out, to be honest. it's like when Iyesus Kristos said that, he wasn't trying to be an ass. You know, he was probably surprised. He's all like, what? You're a master? You don't know this? It's like, man, things are worse than I thought. But the way that, you know, it's just that you gotta understand that when one is developed spiritually, and I'm not saying that I am or anything, but when one learns and receives things, for example, when I read a message, I hear a voice, and I feel what is being, I feel a certain vibration coming from that message, sometimes more clearly than other times. But when I read even if it's a texted email message, I hear the voice of a female, or I hear the voice of a man, and I feel the vibration being reflected off of those thoughts. And I'm not, I don't have superpowers, I'm just being straight up, I'm being honest. And so, and I'm a rookie, you know, I'm a newborn. And so, I'm gonna just assume, and this, you know, it's a fact, this is an opinion, an assumption, but I'm pretty sure Wendem Yadam just knew exactly where he was coming from, and it wasn't a Christ perspective. And so I'm pretty sure he just by reading it, you don't even have to put it in a certain way, you just know it's like this, he ain't up to no good, you know what I'm saying? So that I mean, that's just, but like I said, that's an opinion. But nonetheless, I'm pretty sure, especially women can kind of like grasp this explanation a little better, I would think, because of their intuitive nature, their intuition, their ability to be intuitive like that. So let us continue by so greater means and literal, and okay. So let us. It's because, I mean, it's funny how I took notes and everything. I mean, I apologize. I'm supposed to be serious about this, right? But he starts commenting on like just because you've been reading the parables since 1992 don't mean that whatever. Well, let me say something. The race is not for the swift, but for the sure, for them that can endure. It don't matter if like the parables of the seed, even, you know, some rise it quickly, but then they faded away. Even like I had this other thing came to mind, this other scripture where well, it's not a scripture, but it was it's knowledge coming from a Gentile elder that I came across long ago, and he made mention that Jesus and the Father are quick to give profit to the wicked man. It's like the people that do evil, like they get rewarded really quick. But the righteous, it's like they have to wait, because their time is not till long time. Because it's not that they're not to receive a good reward, but it's rather that the Almighty is kind of like doing like just giving whatever like insignificant rewards the wicked seek, giving it to them. Yeah, have your little fun, and because I'm gonna do away with you really quick, you know, have fun, you know, pretend that everything's cool, and I'm gonna destroy you. But I don't want to deal with you, you know. I need to pay attention because I'm setting up something good for I and thy righteous, you know. That's basically what it comes down to, you know, like I believe it was Isaac that didn't have his firstborn till, I believe scripture says something like they were well, they were pretty old, right? And one of his brothers, I can't even recall the scripture all that well, but one of our fathers had his children like really late in his life, you would think, but what, you know, is the arm of the Lord too short? Who cares, you know? Jah control the business, and so Jah do what he gotta do, and if we wait a little longer than whatever, so be it. That means that what he set up for you is that much more skillfully and carefully crafted, you know, and formed and shaped. And so it took longer, it took more detail, more precision, more love, more time. And so thus we can conclude that, well, what we were trying to get to is how he, Tobijah, the demon spirit speaking in the form of Tobijah, is making mention that, oh, just because you've been studying since 1992, well, yeah, I would say that that's something to be honored, because I can't say I have even, I don't think I rank up to even beyond a decimal percentage of what Wendem Yadwin has gone through as far as time in the faith. So yeah, I would say that it does have a lot to do that he's been studying the parable since 1992, unlike what Tobijah, the demon spirit inside of him, is trying to say that doesn't matter. Yeah, it does matter, because that proves longevity and faithfulness. I think it's more faithful to be to be in it for like 50 years, you know, especially those years that have been different and tougher, and where information has been harder to be received and acquired, and where communications weren't that advanced and stuff like that. So basically what I'm trying to say is that to disprove the false philosophy that if you've been doing this for a long time, it doesn't matter. It does matter. I mean, honestly, that's to be respected. Yeah, definitely. I could be preaching this right now, and I don't know what I'm gonna do tomorrow. And so no, we could, you know, if we were to suppose, we could make the assumption that it's more possible that Ras Iadonis will still be here tomorrow doing the same thing than it is for I and I to conclude that I will be doing the same thing, because he's got way more years invested in this, to where he's shown his stability, you know, through thick and thin. And so I just felt that was necessary to make mention. So let us continue. Now, he's saying, the demon spirit, you know, in the form of Tobijah, saying that taking the parables literal, taking the Bible literally is wrong. That is wrong. The Bible is literal, and it is metaphysical, and it is geometrical, and it is mathematical, and it is literal, and it is physical. I mean, well, excuse that. And it is artistical, and it is musical, and it is everything. But how can Rastafari really say that the Bible is not to be taken literal? It is. See, that's one of the tricks, and we put out a message a long time ago. That the demons, them, they'll say, yeah, the Bible is true. It's the most accurate book in the world. It is this. It is that. It's got all the information. But they'll set the condition of, but it, not literal. It never happened. You see, they want to take away the humanity of Christ. And this is like deja vu. I was right there when when I said that. But yeah, it's like they want to, like. When good has been triumphant and the seals have been loosened, the enemy's got no other choice but to kind of like side with the enemy before the enemy turns you over to the judges. And so they're gonna their next best option is to kind of be like, okay, well, let's kind of promote the Bible, but let's infect the dis-ease and discomfort of convincing everyone not to take it literal, because then they're going to reject the humanity of Christ and the humanity of God the Father. And so that's what they're trying to do, you know. So by not taking the book literal, it'll lead you away from receiving the only thing that can save you. You can learn the science, you can learn the metaphysics, you can learn everything, but if you don't have the living and walking exemplary life of Gita Jesus Christos, you ain't going nowhere. You need to humble it thyself, bow to him that is to be bowed, and as the bow of a ship, as we said in the days of old, and let Gita Jesus drive the vessel and steer our waves and guide us towards life more abundantly. It is whenever I'm in control and I'm driving, it's like I'll be in a shipwreck quick, but only him knows how to drive the vessel and steer it accordingly. So that's basically that right there. It's like our vessel, as our church, needs someone to drive it, and that's Gita Jesus. And by not accepting the literal aspect and reality and truth and fact of the matter of the Holy Scripture, then we can't do anything with all that knowledge and information if we don't have an example to follow. And that's another thing. You can know everything about the solar system, you can know everything about math, you can know everything, but the practicality, you cannot put it into action, you cannot put it into play, you cannot live it if you don't have Gita Jesus Christos. And that is extremely important that we overstand. It's we'll go into that. It seems like we're gonna have to do another video for that, but in John, it's John chapter 7, we'll go over how Jesus says, why do you seek to kill me? And you seek to kill me, he says a couple of times. And what he's saying, the word kill in that instance in the Greek, it's more of a separate the verb from action. So it's like if you're saying loosening, to separate loose from in, from preventing it to be an action. So yeah, you can have knowledge, but that doesn't mean you're knowledgeable, or you know, or you're act, or you can acknowledge, act on that knowledge. They want to take away the acting from the script. And so, you know, keep that in mind. We'll go into more detail. As a matter of fact, we're going to pause right there, and we're going to grab, we're going to drink something and just like rest for a few seconds, and we'll be right back with the rest of the video. And, you know, I pray that ones don't take offense to this, and especially Tobijah. We pray that the day cometh when he can review this material side by side in the same common in the same common goal, commonwealth alongside Rastafari with one doctrine, and see how this was a benefit to the Rastafari community and the community worldwide that are lovers of truth. So, you know, stay tuned. Shalom, Rastafari.